calcareous organisms are called hardpollinate, like barnacles and diatoms, and non-calcareous organisms are called soft pollinate, like algae and seaweed. As the hull of the ship is constantly immersed in the water for several years, these pollens gradually build up in the hull of the ship, causes significant hydrodynamic drag on the ship. This drag on the ship impedes its passage through the water, resulting increased fuel usage, causing higher operational environmental costs. It has been estimated that if the hull of the ships were left untreated, then it would cost the shipping industry approximately $3 billion per annum. In addition to this, when these ships are placed in a dry dock, this includes the cost to clean the hull and the downtime, which are estimated at approximately $2.7 billion per annum. In addition to these economical cost, it also affects on the environment by producing large amount of carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxide, unburned hydrocarbons, ozones, etc. So due to this default, an antifoulant usage is necessary to the ship of hull of the ship. At first, organotin compounds are used as an antifoulant. These antifoulants generally dispersed in the paint as it is applied to the hull. Normally, tributylene tin oxide mainly used as an antifoulant, and this is the structure of tributylene tin oxide. Now, how it works? Tributylene tin oxide gradually leaks from the hull and killing the falling organisms surrounding the area. Now, as the use of these organotin compounds, organism does not deposit it on the hull of the ships. So economically, marine industry benefited, but its use hampers environmentally in different way, because the half-life of tributylene tin oxide very much. The half-life of tributylene tin oxide in seawater is greater than 6 months. So it is found in the ocean sediment as well as the water, and consequently its bioconcentration in the bioconcentration increases in the marine life. Consequently, it bioconcentrate in the marine organisms. As a result of bioconcentration, it hampers the marine life in the various way, like it deforms the thickness of oyster shells, sex changes in the whales, as well as imposes in the snails. It also hampers the immune system in dolphins, fish, and other marine organisms. Due to this demerits, January 1st, 2003, IMO, that is International Maritime Organization, banned it globally. Japan already banned it as an antifoulant, and in US they form an act which is Organotin Antifouling Paint Control Act of 1988, by which they banned it as an antifoulant. So now development of a new antifoulant is necessary, which acts as an antifoulant like TBTO, but its toxicity must be minimum so that it cannot hamper environmentally. So first, Rom and Haas company developed the C9211, which acts as an antifoulant. Due to the discovery of this antifoulant, they awarded Presidential Green Chemistry Challenge Award in 1996 in the category of the design of chemicals which are less toxic than current alternatives. The main composition of this antifoulant is 4,5-dichloro-2N-octyl-4-isothiazolin-3-one, which is shortly called DCOI. This is the structure of DCOI. Now, how it acts as an antifoulant? When the organism attached to the hull, proteins at the point of attachment with the hull react with DCOI, and consequently it prevents the use of these proteins for other metabolic process. And due to this reason, the organism detach from the hull and searches for a more hospitable surface on which they grow. So by using this antifoulant, environmental risk mitigated by reducing the toxicity of the compound as well as by exposure to the nature. It mainly active towards algae and diatoms at concentration of around 10 ppb and for barnacle at ppm levels. However, the environmental risk of DCOI is minimum because when it leaks from the hull, it rapidly decomposes in the presence of some microorganisms which already present in the seawater, and this is the decomposition process. But due to shortening of the half-life of DCOI, it cannot persist in the marine life, unlike TBTO. DCOI is also not chronically toxic. So these are the advantages of the DCOI, and due to this reason, from the green chemistry view, DCOI mainly used as an antifoulant in the marine life. And the risk quotient can be calculated by the ratio of the predicted environmental concentration of a compound and the concentration of a compound in the environment at which prediction indicated there will be no effect on an organism. The risk quotient value for DCOI is in the range of 0.24 to 0.36, whereas for TBTO it is 15 to 430. It's not for TBTO, it's for organotin, 15 to 4:30, indicating a significant risk to marine life. So from this discussion we can easily understood that DCI is more safe for as an antifoulant.